behind me here is Dog's Grave. Someone told me about this. In fact, Mick, the four-wheel driver who drove me into the start point today on the four-wheel drive track, told me that if I get the chance to go down to the Dog's Grave, it's a track that goes down there. Now, I've just looked at that on my mapping device, and it could be about another 3 kilometre detour. So as much as I'd like to go down there and have a look at the Dog's Grave, I just can't afford to today, especially with the mileage being so high. In fact, if I was finishing in 8 kilometres like I thought I was going to, before I did the double day, I definitely would go down there. But I think the story is that one of the old pioneers or drovers or something, dog sort of passed away when they were obviously moving through the high country here, and he buried it and made a grave there. And all these years later, it's still there, and a bit of a tourist attraction, which is a bit sort of strange. Bit cute, I suppose. So I'm just going to keep bashing up this dirt road. I've got about 7k left until we get to the halfway point today, where I'm going to celebrate with a peanut butter and jam sandwich, and then I will bash on for the next 30, and hopefully it doesn't take me too long. This is the first sign I've come across today as well, so forest road conditions, narrow roads, blind bends and slippery. It's got a picture of a logging truck, so not very nice, is it? Seen it, the logging. Saw so much of that, a few days ago. Just patches of land, just trees is gone. It's disgusting. And this is just a dead trees, limbs may fall. So nothing too exciting. All right. So that's Dog's Grave. I hope there's not going to be a man's or runner's grave out here. So I'll say I've got about 37 kilometres now left today, and hopefully I can just keep cracking on. No big climbs, but this is the BNT and it's full of surprises, so see how I go.